all signs, welcome to your weekly reading for the period of August 22nd until August 28th. If it resonates, consider a personal reading. Just send me an email. Otherwise, we're going to start with Leo for this week. So Leos, you all are you're about to charge in regards to something and not have any fear. You're being really impulsive about it, so be careful about it. About this. This is a relation to somebody, a past relationship that you can't seem to let go of. I think nostalgia has gotten the best of you. And I think you're thinking this week, oh, if I just charge in there with all this passion and all this glory and everything else, maybe we'll be able to get back together. I don't think that that's necessarily the best idea. I don't think what you're thinking with your head right now. I think you're really thinking with your heart. And I think you're thinking in a very like noble sense or real like fairy tale sense. You know, you're just going to rush in. And just think about what could possibly happen if that's not the case. So be really careful about that. Don't do anything hasty just because you're really attached to somebody, I'm just feeling it's a real fairy tale like declaration of your love, and you're hoping or you're thinking it's going to turn out really well. But I don't think that's necessarily the best thing for you, nor do I think that that's actually how it's going to turn out. Next, we have Virgos. Virgos, you all are storming in to cause some kind of upheaval, something kind of going on. You know it's the right thing to do. It might be some kind of truth that you're delivering. It's a very intelligent, wise decision you're making, and you know that this is the only path and the clearest path, and that this has to happen. But as a result of you doing this, I think that it's really going to shake things up. Huge change is going to come out of it. There could be destruction. There could be all sorts of things. And that's okay, because sometimes change, radical change, needs to happen in order for great things to come out of something. And I feel like you guys are going to be the people that are actually going to be starting that this week. Next, we have Libras. Libras, you all are kind of opening yourself up to be judged. You're having judgment about yourself in regards to how you should be moving forward. You're making a huge decision. It's like a life decision. And you kind of told yourself, I'm going to do this and I'm not going to be looking back. And as you guys do, you address everything very fairly and, you know, carefully weigh everything, and balance everything out before you go ahead and you do an action. So it's not like you haven't thought about it, but you have decided once and for all. And I do feel like what it is having more opportunities available to you and pursuing some opportunities that you normally would not have. I feel like you might have been holding back, and now you're just kind of like, let me throw myself out there and see what's available. Let me throw out a wider net and pull it back in and see what kind of fish I get. Let me talk to people I wouldn't ordinarily talk to, or date people I wouldn't ordinarily date, or go into some profession I normally wouldn't think of. So I really think you're making a decision to move forward and start doing that so you can have more options available to you. Next, we have Scorpios. Scorpios, you all are very passionate about a new idea, a new project, a new romance, whatever it is, it's all... it's something you're very excited about. The Ace of Wands, to me, is very much about urgency. And you're excited, so you want to do it right away. But the thing is I think that you're going to have to loosen your purse strings a little bit. I feel like you will have to put money into it or spend a little bit of money. Like, for instance, if it's a new romance or something like that, you might be taking them out on expensive dates. If it's a new project, you might have to invest in it monetarily. So you might have to, like I said, loosen up your purse strings a little bit in order for this to happen and for it to get off of the ground. Next, we have Sagittarius. Sagittarius, really, you're really, really trying to be optimistic this week, and I really think that you're pulling it off. You're trying to do the things that you like, to feel radiant, to feel sunny, to feel warm. Some of you might be getting away to go on a vacation, kind of be in that environment, because there's something that is bothering you. There's a black cloud that's kind of hanging over your head, and I think you're just realizing you don't have any control over it, and there's nothing you can kind of do about it. But what you can do is actually be in the present moment and be positive in the present moment. So even though this black cloud is kind of following you around and making you a little bit sad, I think you're doing what you can possibly do to kind of push it out of your mind. Capricorns, this week, I feel like you're coming out of a place of sorrow, a place of grieving, a place of something that you were very kind of upset about. And now you're actually things are starting to fall into place. You're starting to feel like your old self again. The thing is that whatever this was, I feel like you aren't going back to it. And I think you've drawn specific lines in the sand about expectations and how you want things moving forward and that you aren't going to compromise. Be careful, because for some of you, you might have set the bar a little bit too high. So you might need to bring it down a little bit more, or you're going to set yourself up for disappointment this week. Next, we have Aquarius says, you all cannot decide on something this week, and you should not decide on anything this week. Okay, there is a decision between two things, and you really don't know what to do. So really the best thing for you is to do nothing at this time. Just kind of wait and see what other information is forthcoming that can maybe help you in your decision. But the Two of Swords is here twice, and that's really a card of indecision, but it's also a card of, it's a very sedentary card for me. It doesn't call for action. It just calls for you to kind of sit in, use your intuition, and soak everything in. You can always make a decision a little bit later. This isn't a decision that you need to make right this second. Next, we have Pisces. You all are moving out of something that was hugely toxic. You probably stayed in it longer than you needed to. We do have the card of Capricorn here, if that resonates, but you've decided to pack up all your stuff and leave. It could have been a relationship. It could have been an employment. It could have been a physical place of residence. It just was not a good environment for you to be in. And you guys are very sensitive, and you're very affected by your environment and other people's emotions and things like that. So I think you're making the decision to move out, to move to a better place. You're having some regrets, but you know it's a necessary transition. Aries, you all are having a situation where I feel like somebody is being a little bit of a chatterbox behind your back, talking ill of you, possibly slander. It's not anything that they would possibly say to your face. It could be more than one person kind of doing this. You're kind of making the decision this week to move forward from that. We do have this card of Scorpio here, if that resonates, but you're deciding that you can't kind of let this stuff hold you down. You can't get dragged down in this kind of energy. There's nothing healthy about it. So you're moving forward from it because you're just not going to kind of get stuck in that kind of whatever vibe that person or those people are kind of putting out. So I like to see that. Next, we have Taurus. You all are finished putting investment into something, putting time, putting energy, sacrificing into something. You've decided, nope, I'm done with this. I'm over with this. I don't need to do this anymore. And in fact, you're considering other opportunities. So there may be a kind of lingering sensation where you say to yourself, okay, well, you know, maybe I should stay here because it's safe and it's something that I know and it's something that, you know, I'm comfortable with. But I think once you kind of added things up and saw how things panned out, you're realizing that that is not going to serve you, and it's not going to serve you well, and there's better opportunities out there if you take a risk and leave this thing behind you. So you've definitely decided that you've invested too much into this, and you're ready to take on something new and leave this behind you. Next, we have Geminis. Geminis, you all have closed up a chapter in regards to your life. You've learned all the lessons that are there to learn. The World card is pretty much about that. Having gone through this phase, and you've gotten everything that you can possibly get out of it. And now it's time to kind of like set sail for something new. Open up a new chapter. Sometimes it's about traveling. Maybe you've learned everything where you currently live. And hey, it's time to see the world now and stop being so sedentary. Whatever it is, or however it applies, I feel like the next chapter, there's going to be a lot of work involved, almost to the point of backbreaking, almost to the point of being exhausted and stressed out. So whatever this next thing you're getting into that really has, you know, is going to be very, very hard work, keep in mind that it's okay to ask for help. It's okay to delegate to other people. You don't have to take on responsibilities that don't belong to you. And I'm thinking this might be like a work situation. So some of you might be leaving a previous employment, have learned everything, you move into something else, and then you end up doing things that are more than your job description actually entails for you. And then finally, we have the card of Cancer. You all are moving on from a situation where it has affected your home environment, it has affected your family, or you might be moving out of a situation like that where there's a lot of arguments, there's a lot of toxicity, there's a lot of people not on the same page, not kind of getting along. So you decided it's time to move on from that. We do have the card of Death here, which is the card of Scorpio. So that may resonate for you, but whatever this situation is, you're not going to have it. You guys aren't the type of person to hang out in a home environment or family environment that is not conducive to you, or it is not helpful to you. So you are getting out of it and moving on to something healthier. That's what I have for you. If it resonates, consider a personal reading. Otherwise, good luck to you for this week. Adios from Veronica Garnett. Bye.